Hello everyone and welcome back to Pokémon Alpha Sapphire Blind Insanity Nuzlocke. We're in this next episode now. We defeated Winona in the last episode, and I made a comment about how I feel like gym leaders are going easy on me. And I'm not sure if I like that very much, because it makes me not as proud as I should be to be getting this far. So I decided to jinx myself and say, hey, we haven't had a death in a while! So let's see if that causes anything to happen. Before you guys are thinking, obviously I'm not gonna let someone die on purpose. That would be the dumbest thing I could possibly do. But, can you see me? No! What is the purpose of these trainers? They're supposed to be hidden in the tree. You're not supposed to be able to see them. You have to actually talk to them. I swear, I think that's a complete oversight on the game, or on Game Freak. I think they forgot to do that. They forgot to give the Ninja Boys line of sight. I seriously think they forgot to do that. But what the heck do I know? That's just my thoughts. Whatever. We're gonna use Psybeam on it. And it's gonna die in one hit. Nice job, Rupee. I told you you're not gonna suck. Everyone thought you're gonna suck. Except I don't know what anyone said yet, because I haven't posted a single video at the point of making this one. At least recording it. Self... Nice try coughing. I like your attempts at making this Nuzlocke more difficult. I really do appreciate those attempts. Sadly, they were in vain. We're gonna Naira so we can intimidate. So if you use a self-destruct again, it won't do as much damage. And because Surf is special and it's also raining. Rain. It's raining. I don't know. I don't know. It died in one hand. Good job. Yay. And yay, we defeated Sunow, I think that's how you pronounce it. Probably wrong. Did someone need healing? Yes. Rupee. From the self-destruct. And I was gonna buy more lemonades, wasn't I? Yeah, let's go do that before I forget. I'm gonna fly back to Mauville real quick. I will meet you back right here. Alright guys, we're back. I just wanna mention two things about flying. First of all, when you fly and you chose your trainer making the Pokemon come out of its ball, it actually keeps the Pokeball that your Pokemon is in. Like, I know this because Real isn't a great ball, and he actually pulled out a great ball and came out of that. I know that might not mean too much to you guys, but I always find that cool whenever they try to incorporate what type of Pokeball they're in into things. And this lady has a cast form who just likes changing the weather just for the fun of it. At least that's what they did in the old games, at least when I fought it. All it did was constantly change between the weathers just so it could show off that it has that ability. And that did, like, nothing. What the heck, man? Let's actually switch, I guess. I think that time has come, Rupee. I don't want it to come yet. Go to one. Yeah, that's the first thing I want to mention. I think that's pretty cool. Secondly, I confirmed Mauville to be a giant building. Because you cannot use fly in any part of Mauville except for when you're on the roof, or when you're in the center, by the Pokemon Center, in that middle ground area thing. So yeah. Rain Dance. Ooh, clever. You're getting rid of your ice weakness. Or you're getting rid of your weakness to fighting, because you're changing from... Interesting. Except now its speed is lower, so I should be fine. Heh heh. Goodbye. So yeah, Mauville is confirmed to be a giant building. It's not a town. Don't get me started. Or don't let them tell you otherwise. Dual Chop! Dual Chop! That is a dragon move! Holy crap! Yes, I want to learn that. But what the heck do I get rid of? I'm thinking about getting rid of Revenge, because I have not been using it lately. Because I never think, ooh, I'll probably go second. Yeah, I don't think to use it, so... No revenge for me. I already got my revenge in this playthrough, which was defeating Archie. So, we're fine. And Ruby wants to learn Toxic. That's basically a better version of Poison Powder. So, let's get rid of it. Although Toxic, 90. Poison Powder, 75. Yep. Toxic's basically a better version. And I know Toxic also does badly poison instead of just regular poison, which means the poison gets worse every turn. So, Ruby can now be a staller if I really wanted her to be. So, yay. I guess. Who's this trainer up here? I don't know. Ruby can probably fight. Maybe? I don't know. We'll see. Well, you have many abilities. If you want to become a first-class trainer, learn about them. I know about every ability out there. Give me ability, you name it. I'll tell you what it's about. I'm not trying to sound cocky, but I'm a massive Pokemon nerd. I'd be surprised if you found something I don't know about it. And holy crap, that is a Melodic. It is raining, and it's a Melodic. I know I said that twice, but oh my god, we might be in trouble here. Let's start by giving it a Toxic. Twister. Oh, if it's gonna use crappy moves like Twister, we don't have to worry. So we're fine. All right, so now that's badly poisoned, I could just stall it out. But poison, I'm gonna assume it uses special moves. Let's use a light screen. It's just using Twister though. Seriously, Twister? Seriously? Twister. You're a Milotic. However the heck you pronounce your stupid name. Refresh. Oh! Ooh, you got me there. Got me there. Well played, Milotic. Well played. Yeah, okay, this is going to be harder than I thought. Well, fine. I'm going to talk to you again. How do you feel about that? And it's a water pulse. Crap, 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 crap. Thank you, Rupee, for surviving. Okay. We're not going to stay in because another water pulse can kill you, Rupee. I really pray this trainer does not have healing items, or this is going to take forever. And you know what, Melodic? Pretty sure learns a recover naturally. This is not good. Let's go to Guarani, because super effective Giga Drain. And one, for some reason, I did not heal in last battle. So, I am a big dum-dum. Big dum-dum. Big dum-dum who give gum-gum. Twister again. Oh, at least... Twister. Never mind. It's going easy on me again. I know that didn't do much very much because Melodic has very, very high special defense. But whatever. And my light screen... I just realized that light screen was in effect. Heh. It does no recover. Oh, God. We are so dead. Oh, my God. We are so dead. Confuse Ray Guarani. It's our only hope. Guarani! You're confused! No, this can't be happening. And you're going to be dead in one more hit, aren't you? Fine, confused. Can refresh heal confusion? Because that would suck. Let's try Nyra. Because you resist water. So the only thing they got against you is Twister. That's not that good. And I think Melodic's physical defense... I mean, it's not weak by any means, but it's lower than special defense. Oh my god, this is not good. We are so dead. Oh my, asleep! It's asleep! But that did hardly anything! That was the wimpiest attack I've ever seen, Nyra. Wimpiest attack ever. I don't know how we're gonna beat this. It's asleep. Do I keep in Nyra so I can try to put it back to sleep if it wakes up, or do I switch out to do more damage? How much more damage will I really do? Let's go to Quetzal. Still asleep, okay. It's so gonna just heal as soon as it wakes up. I don't know how we're gonna win this, guys. It woke up, but at least it's still confused. It didn't hit itself, though! Quetzal, Quetzal, no! Oh my god, we are so dead. We are so dead. It's gonna use Recover again. Nyra, you're back up. Still confused. Please do something. Please, confusion. Thank you. Thank you so much for doing something. Secret power. Put it to sleep again. Please put it to sleep again. No, it didn't put it to sleep again. Hit yourself. Hit yourself. It did. It used Twister. Okay. Thanks. Appreciate it. Real appreciated, man. Woman. Thing. Snake thing. Water snake thing that it recovered and ran out of confusion. Oh, this is impossible. Critical hit, but not put to sleep. You need to put it to sleep. That is the key here, Naira. And that was a critical. Okay, that was a critical hit. Thank you. Unless it gets a second critical hit, Naira will still Naira will survive one more attack. Twister. No, 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 no. Crap. What do I do? I gotta just hope I put it to sleep again. That is the only thing I can go for here. I mean, I could switch out to Real to have a person with a little more HP do some work, and maybe Juan for a short time, but I don't trust that. Oh my god. Because even if they do survive attacks, they're not going to do very much, and she'll just heal. That's why we're screwed here. That is why we are screwed. Naira, I'm going to put my faith in you one more time. No, but yes! Yes! You did it, Naira! Keep it asleep. Please keep it asleep. Use strength now. It's a little stronger. We got it! Oh my god. We got out of that without losing anybody. Oh my god. In the game's defense, though, it did go for Twister quite a bit. If it had only gone for Recover and Water Pulse back and forth and Refresh, it would have killed someone. But no. Again, I think it went easy on me. Pretty sure it could have killed Naira. Pretty sure it could have killed Naira if it really wanted to. But no, it did not. So yeah, that was a fun battle. I cannot believe we got out of that. And honestly, it was because Naira got some really lucky hits with the sleep. It's also because she didn't try very hard. I'm serious. Twister is a god-awful move. Why would she wasted turns by using it? I don't get it. I really don't get it. Did they try to make this game easy? And by easy, I don't mean easy in itself. Easy as in giving the player a chance. They shouldn't do that. I really don't think they should do that. If you lose, it's because you did something wrong, or a critical hit, or the opponent out-strategied you. Those should be the only reasons you lose in battle, not because someone used the wrong move because they weren't thinking. And I don't know, I guess I can use that in terms of a real-life opponent, but you're not going to tell me that the game cannot calculate what move would be the best to use at this moment in time. And you're also not going to tell me that she used those attacks randomly. So yeah, I don't know what to think. All I know is that I'm glad we got out of that alive, but I'm not so glad at the fact that I think the game is going easy on me. Oh, I was so caught up in my thing that I didn't point out this trainer. I'll try hard. He is so funny to me. I know the only playthrough I pointed that out is my Ruby Hack Nuzlocke, but no one watched that because it's sucky. At least in my opinion. Because it's a game that I made and hacked and it was crappy. But yeah, I think he's hilarious. He just says, "Want a battle?" And then he beats me and says, "I lost." Talk to him, "I'll try harder." He's just like, so like depressed and casual about it. Like, "Oh, I'll try harder. Oh, I lost." I don't know, I think he's funny. So yeah, we're going to continue on this route and put this whole melodic thing behind us. And is there another Kekle on this bridge? No, there's not. But it did stop raining. That's a plus. Is down here considered another route? I'm pretty sure it is. Well, not yet, but when it starts to go right, I'm pretty sure it's a new route. Is there anything over here? I think you give me berries for free. It's a way to show love? Sure. An Ayapapa berry! Yay! It's rare. What's up here? Secret bases and more berries. I don't really care to pick them. Wait, yes, I do. They're berries. I love berries. What kind of berries are they? Petcha. 6 berries? 6 berries. And people thought I was crazy when I loved the berries in the Hoenn games and said the others were not as good. 6 berries. 4 berries, another 4 berries. Berries. Alright, up here, I'm pretty sure it just goes to a trainer and the place you find Registeel. So I'm not going to go up there. So yes, we're going to keep going down this way. And I don't care to find that. But I do care to fight you. And you're going to check me to see if they're fit for the outdoors. Well, all of them were caught in the wild, which was the outdoors. And although I don't know how long they lived there, I think they were doing just fine before I captured them and forced them to fight for me in my Nuzlocke of Death. So yeah, they're very fit for the outdoors. It's just, I'm bringing them to their death by forcing them to come along on this journey. Ariel even told me he didn't want to leave his cave. He loved his cave with the million Zubats. And now he's just confused about this whole thing. He just can't think anymore. So I'm going to switch him out and give him a time to think and clear his head. And we're going to switch to Ruby. And this is Nuzleaf. He has Leaf Blade? Not that it's going to do a lot of damage. I just was not aware Nuzleaf learned Leaf Blade. Oh, Venoshock is running low on PP. Heh. I should either restore that or use a healing point sometime soon. I'm pretty sure we get yet another healing point on this next route. This game has been very, very generous with those, because there were so many places they added in the game where they just randomly decide to heal you. Like, for no reason. And this is even electric. We haven't seen one of those yet. I'm going to go to Guarani because you resist electric. Bite. Nom nom. I'm sure Guarani doesn't taste very good. She's like a plant that's like hundreds of thousands of years old. Even if you're a vegetarian, that doesn't sound very good. And yay! That did damage and healed you. That's what Giga Drain does. Odor Sleuth, oh no! How dare you! And yeah, we're gonna finish it off. Let's finish it off with Brine. Save some pee-pee. Thunder Fang, oh no! That'll probably paralyze me or flinch me. Actually, it didn't either. Good job, Guarani. And goodbye, Manectric. Hooray, level for Guarani. Guarani's actually growing higher up than everyone else. Except for Quetzal, of course. I think she's tied with Quetzal now. Because, yeah, things and stuff. I keep having to switch to her because she has a really good type coverage. Yeah, she caught up to being the highest level along with Quetzal. And she still hasn't evolved. So, imagine how good she'll be when she does evolve. Nothing down here. Nothing to see here. How did you see me? That was weird. That was weird, and you guys know it. And this is Pokemon Ranger Jenna, and she has a Lombre. Hey, the other guy had a Nuzleaf. This person has a Lombre. I see the theme here, but I can't imagine what the other Pokemon she has is. I don't know what the equivalent to Manectric would be considered to be. I guess we're going to find out right now. Watch it be just another Manectric. That would be funny. Mean look? Nah. I don't want you looking at people meanly. Might give them the wrong idea. Grumpig? Grumpig. Oh. Oh. Took me just now to realize 3 of my Pokemon are weak to Psychic, and nobody is good against them except Real's Bite. But Real is weak, one of those that is weak to Psychic. So we're going to switch out, and we're going to go to Quetzal. Quetzal the Pretzel. Zen Headbutt. Oh boy. That didn't do very much. Is Grumpig part fairy? Let's use Steel Wing. Just to see. It's not. I had a random... it has Power Gem crap! No, 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 Quetzal! No!
Mitchell!
You were the best one on this team! I told you Quetzal would die! I told you! Way back at the beginning, any Pokemon we ever have in our Nuzlocke that is the go-to person to take care of crap, they die. Every single time. And now I don't even know what to do. It's not like I have someone to, as a backup to use against this stupid thing. I did not think that would do that much. I mean, I saw the Power Gem and I was scared for a second, but wow. That wasn't even a critical hit. That was just a plain old one-hit KO. I think the extra damage from the Zen Headbutt helped, but wow. And the reason in case people have thought I'm stupid for thinking he might be fairy, I know a fairy tale girl early in the game had a Spoink, but I guess I should stop thinking that trainers automatically have a certain type, because clearly I was wrong. So we're going to use some secret power here. Magic Coat? I honestly don't even know what that move does. It didn't affect my attack, so I don't really care. I've never tried to use that move, so I could not tell you what it does. I should have just used Naira. I know Power Gem's not super effective as her, but she's not using it. Oh my god, Quetzal. Why? You're totally fit butt. I care nothing about you or your butt! We're gonna fly back to Fortree, and we're gonna get us a new- we're gonna replace our Pokemon, and that's gonna be the end of this episode, unfortunately. That is terrible. I am so sorry, Quetzal. I did not even think about Power Gem. I do not believe that was a third-gen move. If I remember, I'm pretty sure it was introduced in fourth-gen, but if I'm wrong, it doesn't excuse it any less or more. Goodbye, Quetzal. You were a fantastic member. The last person I lost was Ruble before. I told you, we have not had a death in a while, so I knew the next one that would happen would be a big one. So, who can replace the greatness that was... was Quetzal. Gord, maybe? Because Gord's flying type? Grass flying? I already have a grass type and a flying type. I don't have... There's not a type I have except for Rand the Spoink. Wouldn't that be just a thing? I use Rand in my team? The person who killed Quetzal? The Pokemon that killed Quetzal. I really don't know who I should use in my team at this moment. I'm going to give it some thought in between this and the next episode, so... I will see you then. Thank you for watching this one, and I hope you enjoyed it to an extent. Thank you again for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Rock on.